Hello everyone, my name is Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the technical phone round of the Amazon data engineering interview process. At the end of this video, you should have a pretty good understanding of what this phone round is all about, what interviewers filter for, and a couple of tips on how to prepare yourself for this. As a quick introduction, I'm from Prepfully. We offer anonymous online mock interviews with someone who's worked in your target company and role. There's a host of other interview prep services we also provide, but specifically in the context of this video, we've got a bunch of Amazon data engineers and Amazon data engineering managers who've been helping candidates with mocks as well as advice, and they've also helped us put together content for this video. So, on to the phone interview then. This is step two in the data engineering interview journey at Amazon, and it comes right after you pass the recruiter phone screen. This is typically a hybrid interview. It covers a lot of ground, but usually the interviewer doesn't go too deep into any one topic because they want to get a broad assessment of your skills. I'm going to give you seven things that are going to potentially come up in this interview and a few tips for each of them. Very clearly, not all of them will come up in every interview, but an average interview will cover anything between 3 and 5 of these. The first thing and the most obvious for this round is SQL questions. This will nearly definitely be asked, so be prepared for complicated SQLs to write on top of a data set you're given. Lots of practice is necessary. You should have all the basics in your fingertips, be it subqueries, joins, aggregate functions, group by and having, and so on. You could also be asked to optimize queries. The second thing is LeetCode-style algorithms. Less common, but if you do get asked these, don't forget to ask clarifying questions. Make sure to explain your thought process before you jump into the coding part of it. The third thing is data modeling. When this comes up, it's usually relatively high level, but it can cover any part of the journey from like pipeline design to thinking of the actual schemas and relationships that you'd establish. Fourth thing, leadership principle, nearly definitely going to get asked. Use the star or par format, keep stories concise, prepare the messages you want to deliver well in advance, well before the interview. The fifth thing is technical discussions. So this can by itself be a really large number of topics. For instance, some of our candidates reported that they were asked questions related to Spark and EMR. Others were asked questions related to data warehousing. Some folks were even asked like BI concepts such as dimension modeling, OLTP versus OLAP, and so on. Whereas others who had some background in database administration were asked how they'd like maybe tune the performance of a particular database. Sixth then is reporting tools such as Excel and Tableau. This nearly never comes up now. To caveat this, it's really rare for this to be part of an interview, unless of course it's explicitly mentioned in the job description. And seventh and final is your technical experience. So if you've mentioned something you're technically competent in, they might dig into that. So one of our candidates had said that he's very familiar with AWS, so he was asked questions relevant to that. You could also be asked about previous technical projects you've done. So that's the sort of stuff that could potentially come up. I've got two generic tips as well. The first is you need to be super succinct. You need to cover a lot of ground in this interview because there's a lot of things you're being tested against. So you don't want to let just one topic hijack the entire conversation. And the second tip is practice, because it's hard to be concise when you're asked questions you don't normally think about in like on a day-to-day basis. So practice with colleagues, with fellow candidates, practice with data engineers at Amazon if you can get hold of them, get feedback on your stories, get used to having questions thrown at you that you might not be completely expecting. If you know a data engineer at Amazon, great. If you don't, you can always reach out to them on LinkedIn and ask for help, or you can book a mock with a professional data engineer at Amazon on Prepfully, and we could get something set up for you here as well. Cool, that's all from me. That's our guidance from us at Prepfully and our Amazon data engineering experts at Prepfully on how to rock this phone interview. Once you feel ready for some practice, you can book a mock interview. There's a link in the description below. I'm also going to include a bunch of other helpful resources such as interview questions and a guide that goes into a lot more depth that I've covered so far. So you can check those out as well. If you have any follow-up questions about the interview, please let me know. Ask in the comments below. And if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Cool. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.